Mark from 93.7.
Nice to meet
you,
Mark.
How
you
doing? Good. What are you? You're in the House. You're in the.
Yeah, I'm the House Minority Leader. I'm the Democratic leader of the state.
Nice meeting you. I'll let you get some PR.
Had been Republican the year before and had changed over now. And changed over to Republican.
We had a 38-27 Democratic majority, and now it's a 33-32.
It's that
Republican.
Close, just one.
Well, as I like to joke at the state capitol, it's 32-32 and Tom Massey, so. Because Tom's such a moderate thinker, independent thinker.
Are you a state rep, or are you a state? You are, okay. We know Tom Massey pretty well, and Gail Schwartz, and a lot of our knowledge has come from them, as well as our new schools.
Yeah.
And what's going on exciting? Now you're out for a little recess.
Yeah, well, I'm running for the 3rd Congressional District.
Okay.
Which is the western slope in southern Colorado. Chaffee County, a number of people from Chaffee County testified that they like to have Chaffee County moved into the 3rd.
I see. Good.
Out of the 5th, so... both the Democratic and Republican maps put Chaffee County in the 3rd. I hope that's the case.
Who are your opponents, Sal?
Well, right now I'm the only Democrat who's announced. The incumbent Republican is Scott Tipton.
Oh, okay.
And he's out of Cortez. He ran as a moderate, so he's going to protect Medicare and Social Security, and instead has decided to be a right-wing party line foot soldier for the GOP. He voted to eliminate Medicare and defends that proposal. He's taking on the big fights in Washington like Sesame Street and Big Bird.
I see.
I think the 3rd Congressional District and communities like Chaffee County want someone who's focused on common sense, practical solutions instead of continuing the divisive partisan rhetoric.
So it's part of Chaffee County?
Well, it isn't right now, but we're redrawing the lines right now.
Oh, okay.
We're in the process of redistricting.
Redistricting, and that will happen.
It will happen, and most people think Chaffee County will end up back in the 3rd Congressional District.
Uh-huh. And what's the rest of that area, Sal?
Well, it's geographically more than half of the state. From northwest Colorado and Wyoming border, the entire Utah border, southern Colorado along New Mexico from Durango to Lahana.
San Luis Valley is part of your area too.
Yes. It's a district larger than 24 of the states in the United States.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
I didn't realize it was that large. That's interesting.
And so each of the congressional districts have, in Colorado, have 718,000 residents. In Denver, they have one district just in Denver. But for those of us in rural Colorado, it's a much larger geographic district to get to 700.
That is going to be a lot of area for you to cover. You're going to have to go to an awful lot of different places.
Yeah, no, I've announced 6 weeks ago and have been on the road ever since. And put over 3,000 miles on the car.
Our area is really Chaffee County and the San Luis Valley. Also some South Park. Is South Park or Park County in your...
There's no proposals to... Redistricting's not complete, so we don't know. So
right.
Park County could end up in the 3rd Congressional District, but to date, none of the proposals have put Park County in the 3rd.
I see. Well, congratulations on redistricting. I think that's going to help the Democrats. I wish they could do it with the Springs area and Lamborn's, bastion of strength there and change it around and get Pueblo. There has been talk about getting Pueblo into the Springs area.
Yeah, mathematically, the tough thing about Pueblo, it's hard to move it out of the 3rd. You really can't, because you lose such a population base. Roughly 1 in 4 people in the 3rd Congressional District live in Pueblo, so you'd have to find that population base somewhere else.
I understand. Sal, nice to speak with you
at 93.7.
When you get closer, come by the radio station, and we'll talk about
some of
the
things you
have.
Tell me more about your station.